All right, welcome everybody. Today we're gonna do a video on gear in Honkai because the last video I did on gear at this point is super outdated. Now you will notice that in this video we're actually gonna be returning to PowerPoint gaming. Not because that I think PowerPoint videos are better, but because it's actually very difficult for me to create visuals for a gear video. So this video is pretty much gonna be exactly like the last gear video, but I will be talking over it with my extended thoughts. So let's start with event equipment. So this is like stuff that comes around every once in a while, and sometimes they bring it back into the shops, so you really have to keep an eye out for these. If you're around when they first release, it's usually obtainable for free, but usually you'll have to pay Astrite for the older ones. So here are the ones that I recommend and have some use in the endgame. So of these, the most impactful is the fireworks or the Chinese New Year set. The two set of this Stigmata set can actually ignite, which can trigger QTEs by the way. You can buff your entire team with physical damage and fire damage if you combine the top and bottom piece. Overall, it's a really good set, but it just never comes back. The next notable Stigmata sets are the Rebel Blaze and the Bringer of Light set. These Stigmatas are basically on the level of G2 Stigmata, which is actually really strong for a free Stigmata. However, for these, you definitely need the two set at least to make it useful. Currently, we have a set for physical, lightning, and fire, and the ice one is still being released. All right, the last thing I want to know is the Summer Holic set. The only reason why I put it on here is because it has been recommended in the past. However, I've seen them bring it back and it costs a lot of Astrite, and I actually don't think it is worth your Astrite anymore. This set will not even improve your free-to-play scores very much, so it's just really not worth it. Alright, next let's talk about the basic weapons. Basically, there's nothing good here. Everything here is a temporary solution at best, so don't upgrade anything above level 35 in this category. Next, we can talk about the basic Stigmata. First, let's talk about the best free Stigmata in the entire game, which is Gluttony Top. So what this Stigmata does is basically every time you hit an enemy, a little candy will drop, and if you pick up that candy, your entire team will get a massive total damage multiplier. So obviously this is a fantastic equipment for any support Valkyrie. However, when you're first starting out the game, you actually don't have very many support Valkyries to use. So because the multiplier is a total damage multiplier, this is not necessarily an easy thing to build for when we're talking about free Stigmata. So you can actually consider using this on your DPS really early on into the game, and it's actually a good option. However, only when you're fighting more than one enemy, and that is because the next Stigmata we're going to talk about is Jingwei Top. So Jingwei Top gives you an even better total damage multiplier. However, it's only for bosses because it only works when you're fighting one enemy. But for bosses, this is basically one of the best free-to-play Stigmatas you can use. Next, let's talk about the Marco Polo set. So of the Marco Polo set, only the mid piece is really good. The mid piece gives you a 50% crit damage buff, which is insane for a free Stigmata. Though I will amend that early on when you first start out the game, your crit rate is probably really garbage because of low skill levels. So Marco Polo mid is probably worse early on, but it just gets better and better. The Stigmata is just really good as your crit rate gets better. So next we have the Fuhua Musician 2 set. Now the 2 set here is a on standby support set. Basically, when your party member is on standby with this set, they'll get team buffs. The mid piece is a 10% fire damage buff that lasts forever, but the 2 set you'll have to refresh once the buff runs out. So the next page here of basic Stigmatas are all Memorial Stigmatas, which basically means that they all have niche use cases. Basically, only use it if you're using a strategy that needs it. Okay, next let's talk about the raid weapons. So you should do raid if you see it as a new player. All the weapons here are free to upgrade and use. However, pretty much all of them are pretty bad. But the real reason why we upgrade the raid weapons is because of the passive buffs you get here and the active buffs you also get. These buffs can apply to any fight, which basically means you're getting permanent buffs. So of all the raid weapons, the only one worth mentioning is the Grips weapon, which by the way is the Gauntlet. It gives a small total damage multiplier buff, but it's basically the best free-to-play weapon for any DPS type Fuhua. Of course, when we talk about the raid weapons, we also mentioned the raid gacha weapons. These also fall into the raid category because they also give you some passive buffs, but they're only obtainable through the gacha. Now the problem with these weapons is that most of them aren't really used at all, and the other thing is that they're only really put out in special banners. So a lot of players in the endgame basically consider all of these weapons plus 10 attack. So for the vast majority of newer players, these weapons are not worth pursuing. However, if you do end up getting them, it's actually a benefit to your account. So when miHoYo puts out a special banner, this is just one thing to consider in your evaluation. So first, let's talk about Abyss Flower. So this weapon is extremely OP, and it's one of the only reasons why Bright Knight is used to this day. Vermilion Knight basically had the same type of treatment with Might of Anna 2 back in the day. But basically, if you want to take advantage of what Bright Knight is good at, you will need this weapon. Okay, next let's talk about Oath of Judah. And you might be thinking, Kibi, why are you talking about this boomer weapon? It's dead, right? But recently, it's been shown that Mobius can score pretty high with the Oath of Judah. Therefore, believe it or not, we can actually consider this weapon viable. Normally, I would say to be careful with your investments if you want to try something new, because if you mess up, it's a huge waste of resource. But in this case, you can get the plus 10 attack, so it's not a complete waste. Next, let's talk about the Exchange House. So the Exchange House, basically, you can exchange 6,000 red resonators for a stigmata. You can get red resonators in a various amount of ways, but the blue resonators are basically only coming from gacha weapons. You basically get rid of the weapons that are useless to you or are duplicates, and in exchange you can get a weapon from here, or we'll talk about later, you can also upgrade a pre-arm. So as of right now, I would only consider these three weapons from the exchange shop. First off is Blood Dance. So Blood Dance gives a massive elemental debuff of 60%. This is a rare multiplier, so it is really strong. However, I do have to say that the endgame use of this weapon has decreased significantly over the past year. So I do have to add that this is a transitory weapon. Basically, as you get into the endgame, you use this weapon less and less. The next weapon that I recommend is Swan Lake, which has been recently added. This weapon is for Fervent Tempo Delta, and you can actually transition this weapon into Sleeper's Dream later on. Delta should be the target of your willpowers early on, so getting a good weapon for her is also important. Now the last weapon I would consider is Thunder Kikaku. This weapon is only really used in Memorial Arena, and it's become even more niche because of the introduction of the Triple S boss. So actually for most players, I don't recommend getting this unless you're going for top 100 in your Memorial bracket. Now for the Exchange House Stigmata, pretty much all of these are either farmable or just not very useful. The most useful thing that I've always recommended is Newton Bottom, and that is because it has a very rare debuff that is extremely easy to apply. This Stigmata is still useful in Memorial Arena, but in terms of just overall use cases, it's fallen significantly, and the reason why is because of the release of some very OP support Stigmatas, and the same story could be said about Beach May. So personally, I would still recommend to get at least one or two Newtons. However, with your resonators, it is definitely important to consider both G3 and G4 stigmatas if you need them, which is exactly what we're going to talk about next. So next, let's talk about the Universal Mirage equipment. The equipment here is divided into four sections, which are G1, G2, G3, and G4. Basically, the higher you go, the more powerful the equipment, but also the higher you go, the harder it is to obtain the equipment. So let's start off with the weapons that come from this. I think the best weapon here is the Pledge of Sakura. So this weapon will open up an entire Divine Key branch for you, which is extremely helpful, but its way more important use is in the pre-arm. So the pre-arm is only obtainable after level 80, so you should only consider making this after reaching level 80. The weapon can grant a fairly long ignite, which is pretty important for our recent fire DPSs. It also gives a fairly big fire damage debuff, and of course the last thing that is very useful about it is that it has a very high hit count. So the rest of these weapons here are only really useful in Memorial Arena after level 80, so you'll have to evaluate it on a case-by-case basis on any individual strategy that you want to pursue. Let's move on to the craftable stigmatas. So for the G1 stigmatas, the only one that I really want to mention is Leer Bot. It gives 46% physical damage as a standalone piece, which is pretty incredible, though the condition for this is that you have 100% HP, so this is really mostly helpful in Memorial Arena where you can have your HP at 100% all the time, and it's very easy to fill this on a number of physical Valkyries, including the two supports that are meta right now. I would consider this a cheap substitute that works even above level 80. Everything I said about Leer Bot can also apply to Fushi Bot. It's a cheap fire option that you can farm if you don't want to farm all the way to G3. So of all the G2 stigmatas, the most important one is Thallus Mid. The mid piece here gives you a total damage multiplier buff, a pretty hefty one of 20%. Which means you can use this on any Valkyrie that has no mid piece to fill. But also the second part of the stigmata is extremely strong. It gives a 22% undiluted fire damage bonus. For a free stigmata, this is fantastic, and I would recommend it for any free-to-play player. Now the next consideration for the G2s are the support stigmatas Beethoven and Tesla Band. They are on standby stigmatas that are pretty useful, but generally not that high priority for most players. In terms of other G2s, I would look elsewhere for higher value for your resource. So when we finally talk about G3 stigmatas, we're finally getting to a point where the stigmatas are strong enough to be a significant difference from the free-to-play stigmatas. Generally speaking, I would say the G3 stigmatas are a reasonable free alternative to the signature stigmatas on most Valkyries. However, the most troubling thing about the G3 stigmatas is that they are not best in slot, the exception being Anna on some Ice Valkyries. Now, even though they're not best in slot, I would say that they're actually good enough to get by for 90% of the player base, which means if you're in Red Lotus or below, I think this is actually a good investment, especially if you don't have the crystals for the signature stigmata. And of course, recently miHoYo's released a G4 stigmata set. Now the G4 Alicia set is currently the strongest physical set in the entire game. However, we can only say this is true for the Valkyries that do charged attacks. And you also want to be careful with the top piece because it does not buff burst mode. Now finally, let's talk about gacha gear. So your first priority in any gear gacha should be the signature weapon of the main DPS that you want to use. The weapon is by far the highest power spike you can get from any piece of gear. So whenever you pull for a DPS Valkyrie, please make sure you have enough crystals to also get their weapon. Now of course there's going to be exceptions to this rule, but please follow it the best you can. Now of course you may think, what about Stigmata, Kibi? After you get the main DPS weapon, the most important thing for the team after that is the support gear. Support gear in the recent days of Honkai has become extremely overtuned. Recent Valkyries have extremely long DPS windows, and the support gear actually is tuned to adjust for that. The support gear basically gives you a massive buff for the entire duration of your DPS window, and when you compare it to gear that you use for free, it's not even close. This is like level 1 crook versus level 100 mafia boss levels of difference. First, let's talk about Fuhua, which of course I'm talking about the Herster of Sentience and Azure Imperia respectively. So I put these two together because they support the elemental team and the physical team respectively. Now first of all, their weapon is pretty much exactly the same in terms of function. I do recommend you get both, but it is possible to use one glove on the other. The primary use case of the glove is to get a massive amount of SP, and believe me, it is a huge difference to get this SP regen. It almost feels like you're playing a different Valkyrie. In terms of the Stigmata, let's talk about Margrave first. So when you actually look at the pure numbers of Margrave, it doesn't look that impressive. However, the main benefit of this set is that it's categorized in the total damage taken category. Now, of all the new OP A rank Stigmatas, none of them are in this category. And because you don't really use Newton these days, Margrave is basically entirely undiluted. The point is, Margrave makes a much bigger difference than it might seem. This on top of the fact that it gives attack speed, which is almost required on Azure Imperia, it overall just makes a big difference. Now comparing this to the Shattered Sword set is basically best in slot for the Herster of Sentience. Not only does it give a hefty amount of team-wide buffs, it's also quite strong if you use her as a DPS as well. And although it may not seem as important as Margrave, I would consider it as important for physical teams as Margrave is for elemental teams. And of course, let's talk about the OP A-rank support gear. These sets are extremely overtuned and make a much bigger difference than both Margrave and Shattered Swords, so definitely look at these first. There's one set for each elemental team. However, for the first set that you go for, you definitely want to go for a set that is applicable to multiple teams. So both Turgenev and Aslaug are really good. They both can be used on the off-element teams if you don't have the respective gear. For each, the most important piece is the top and the bottom piece. However, the mid piece is also really good for their respective team. So when you compare Shui and Zhen Yi, they're a bit different. When you strictly look at them as a support gear, they're only really good on Charlotte Astrologos and Fischl. However, the damage that they provide is really strong, so these Stigmatas are actually usable on DPS Valkyries as well. Personally, I think that Shui is more important of these two because Starlight Astrologos is just more important to the physical team than Fischl is to the lightning team. However, if you do want to build a good lightning team, then Zhen Yi is a great asset to that. Of course, the final support I haven't mentioned in this video is Fallen Rosemary. Her gear is in a very awkward spot where I would just recommend getting the weapon only. While the Irene set is technically good, it's rather niche. You can definitely get more impactful gear for your account. As for any DPS gear, of course, you'll want the Signature Stigmata. But like I've said earlier, getting the Signature Stigmata for a DPS only helps one Valkyrie for one specific team, and actually the amount that it helps can actually be worse than the support gear. Lastly, we're going to briefly touch on pre-arms. Now, all pre-arms are useful at level 50 because they get a big power spike just from the base form. However, the ones that you should level first are of the DPSs that you use the most. Currently, that is expected to be the Herster of Flame Scion. However, you can make your own judgment here. My recommendation is to make any pre-arm that you expect to use at level 50 first, and then start leveling up the DPS pre-arms that you use the most. Alright, and that's basically everything I wanted to say about gear, so if you have any questions, please leave a comment below.